I'm Giacinto Donvito. I work for National Institute of Nuclear Physics in Italy. I'm involved in both elixir activities since in the beginning. I'm at the moment leading the compute platform for Italian elixir node, and I'm deeply involved in the EOSC context since the beginning. At the moment, I'm following EOSCAB project as a technical coordinator for the full project. After me, Marco Tangaro will speak. He will present himself. Next slide, please. Okay, so a very quick outline. We will try to give you a very quick introduction to the EOSC context as a whole, and then going deeply into the EOSC life, specifications, where specific services and activities will be described by Marco, in order to try to give you some ideas on how those movement or strands could help community like this one that could be somehow interested in exploiting some services. So next slide. Very generally, EOSC is a very widely and open initiative, mainly founded by the European Commission. The original idea was trying to have a federation of services with both the souls, the data part and the computing part infrastructure, in order to provide to the researchers the possibility to access to fair data and services. So data and services that could be easily findable, accessible, indexable, and reusable. So the idea is to build up an open solutions where all the researchers could find the services or the data they are looking for in order to do their research. Obviously, this will take care about the data, the publications, the code, but not only services. So it's a very broadly approach. Obviously, when you design this wide framework, wide environment, you need to take very care of the research infrastructure and the real community of users. And this is the idea. This is starting with the research environment in mind and trying to take on board all kind of research communities. Obviously, the idea is that all the users, all the researchers that have some services could put those services together and bring those services to the wide community in order to add value, so that the services that I'm using could be a value also for another researcher, somewhere else that could be interested in using the same services. Next slide, please. So obviously, we need to focus on some, very simple and general rules in order to build such an ecosystem. Also, taking into account that this, apart from the start that could be founded by European Commission, at the end, it would be somehow able to step on its own feet. So it should be maintainable in the future and should be sustainable in the future. So the idea is that this is focused on research needs. It's not a cloud for a commercial environment. It's a different story. It's specific, intended to serve the researchers. And so it should be community driven. It should serve the community they are building, and it should be intended to solve the problem of each of the community. Obviously, it could not be one single way of doing things. You need to be respectful of the diversity, you need to be inclusive, and you need to take the most of the community on board in order to succeed. And obviously, there is already long story of research infrastructure available in the market. So you need to take on board also the resource provider in a way that it is easier for them to join, also if they are a large research center, for example, the large reality already. This should be open as much as possible in terms of assessing data and services, but obviously not more than what is possible. If you have privacy on data or whatever, this should be respected and this should be supported by the system. And obviously, it should be easy to use, transparent for the end user, and obviously the user should trust on the solutions we are going to provide. Next slide, please. In order to, build such an ecosystem, the European Commission is acting on different levels. They are funding projects. We will see in the next slide. They are funding project for implementing stuff, but they are also funding work in order to define the governance, the policy, and how those kind of services could work together, etc. So here in this picture, I don't want to go into such a details, but here in this picture, you see that it is a very complex ecosystem where there is a governance board, where there is the possibility to make the steer of the process in some sense. There is an executive board, and obviously there is working groups for each of specific topic to be dealt with, etc. And obviously the stakeholders are an important part of this process because they are building the system and they will use the system at the end. Next slide, please. Here you see a kind of roadmap that give you an idea of which kind of project are found, were found, and will be found in the future in order to implement this. You see that this is starting in beginning of 2017, and it's going on also in the next round. I mean, quite surely we will go also in the next round of funds. And at the moment, there are longer list of project that is already going on funded in order to cover specific pieces of the work. So there is a project, for example, like EOSCAB or Open Air Advanced that are more broad. They are working on different topics of the implementation of the EOSC. And there are other projects like, I don't know, ESCAPE, SSHC, or EOSC Live that are working on a specific set of services in order to serve specific community. But there are also project like, I don't know, EOSC Pillar or EOSC Nordic, etc., that are working on region because not all the countries are similar. So for each of the region, you need to make specific activity in order to support those region in a way that could be onboarded into the EOSC ecosystem. And this is the reason why EOSC Live it's specifically working on some topic that obviously is much close to your activity, and then we will deal about EOSC Life in details. So I will leave the floor to Marco at this moment. Next slide. Please,
Thank you,
Marco.
Giorgio. Yes, can you hear me?
Yes, very well.
Okay, thank you so much. I'm going to present EOSC Live, also Elixir, and the services that we are developing in this project. Also, because as you can see in the previous slide, these are projects already ongoing, and some of these services are very advanced or already in production. EOSC Live is a H2020 project, and its consortium groups 13 S3 infrastructures. So the main idea under the EOSC Live project is to publish FAIR data resources, so not only the data but also the resources, group all the ecosystem on of life science tools on the EOSC. So the idea is to port those data and tools to the EOSC ecosystem, and then allow to researchers to exploit it. There are some communities already engaged in EOSC Lab. You can see the infrastructures, and most of the users are coming from these infrastructures. But the idea is to engage new communities through open calls. And finally, in my last slide, we can see the current open call, which is OpenEd, and we will have a look to it. Next slide, please. As you can see, one of these infrastructures is Elixir. So Elixir is the European bioinformatics infrastructure. So the idea under Elixir is to group all the bioinformatics resources like databases, software tools, but also training material, practices, and cloud storage and computing resources, and makes them available to the users. So within Elixir, users can log in into these services. As Giacinto said, it's not that the user can access to the single tools, but the idea is to integrate them and then allow the user to exploit all of them in a new way. Elixir has a central lab, which is located at the Genome Campus in the UK, but we have also 23 national nodes, including Italy, among them. Next slide, please. So services that we are developing. So just a brief introduction, most of them are based on Galaxy. We can switch in to the next slide, as you will see. So what is Galaxy? Galaxy is the prevailing current workflow manager for bioinformatics. It is open and it is web-based and allow accessible, reproducibility, and transparent computational research. Next slide. So this is the interface of Galaxy. The nice thing of Galaxy is that you can install on this this service thousands of bioinformatics tools, and not only for bioinformatics. And all of them don't have a user interface. So all of them has to be run from the command line. So they are not accessible to non-IT experts. So only if you have IT skills, you can run them. On Galaxy, you have this interface. You have on the left the tool list. You can select one of them. You can, in the central panel, enable the option that you need. And on the right, you have the input, the output data. So basically, the user don't have to run them from the command line, but have this nice web interface. Next slide. So how to access to Galaxy? So in the context of Elixir first, and now also on EOSC Life, it is founded the European Galaxy server. It is usegalaxy.eu, so basically you can log in into this portal, you can register, the registration is free, and you have thousands of documented and maintained tools. All of them are tested and comes with reference data if you need them. There is also the possibility to run training on usegalaxy, and there are also a lot of training courses during the year. And there is also the possibility to have several domain-specific versions. I have put all of them in my backup slide if someone is interested. But the idea is that they are supporting also single communities with a specific set of the tools, and anyone can access to them. Next slide. So what happens at national level? So sometimes, of course, we have the law framework, and sometimes you cannot go in usegalaxy.eu server that is located in Germany, and you cannot upload the data there, or you don't want to upload the data there. So there are national Galaxy public server instances that are completely similar to the one from the European server. So same set of tools, basically same set of tools, same set of framework, and there is one for example, for Spain, Norway, France, Belgium. And so people from the national community can go there and analyze their data. What about Italy? We can go to the next slide, please. What about Italy? So in Italy, we don't ever use Galaxy Server, at least we don't have now. We won a call from, also in this case from EOSC. This, the project is EOSC Secretariat. The idea is to build a Galaxy instance for the COVID-19 research. And the idea is to use the framework used published by the Use Galaxy team and to build a national instance starting from the COVID-19 and that extend it to all the needed tools. And this is a already funded project, and we hope to have it up and running for the first part of the 2021. Next slide. The Workflow Hub. So this is a project started within the EOSC Life project. It is a registry. It is not a repository of workflow. It is only a registry, so a place you can go there. You can upload the metadata of your workflow. You can upload data. You can input and output data, for example, and you can organize your workflow. So the idea is that you can allow user to go there to find a workflow that's suitable for their analysis or different workflow for the same analysis and compare them and then access them and use them. This is under development. A basic version is already up and running. And the nice thing is that they are supporting a different workflow manager, not only Galaxy, of course. And the idea is to have let's say, big red button so the user can start from the workflow hub and then to come to the service that can run that particular workflow. There are also some sections for Homo sapiens and COVID-19 dedicated for this workflow. Next slide. Thank you. Here we come to Lanakia. Lanakia has been, as we will see, is supported by Elixir Italy, but also is developing in the context of EOSC, in particular EOSC Life and EOSC Pillar. So here we come. We have already seen some scenarios how to access to a public instance, but there are of course the case basically for the analysis of sensitive data. You don't want or you cannot upload the data on a public server, so you need a private instance. There are of course also other reasons like customization needs, or you want to develop your own software, or you have to run jobs without waiting for the queue, and etc. Next slide, please. For this reason, in Italy, we develop for Elixir Italy, we developed this software, Laniakea. It is a Galaxy on-demand platform. We have a nice user-friendly interface. We will see it in the next slide. And Laniakea allow user to log in into the service, select the Galaxy instance that you want. You can select you can configure the hardware. So you can select the number of CPU, the RAM, the storage that you need. You submit your request, and after 30 minutes, you have your working instance. And the nice thing is that you don't have to learn nothing on the infrastructure or how to install Galaxy. That is everything managed by Laniakea. You have just you will be just provided by a URL address. You can go to Galaxy and you can start. Next slide. So this is the interface of Laniakea. So you it's quite simple. You have icons. You push the button and you can start to. You have a quick explanation of what we are going to deploy, and then you can use Galaxy. Thank you. Next slide. So I don't want to stress more on Laniakea, but I want just to highlight two features. The first one is that you can encrypt your the user data, and this is very nice because improve the compliance of these services and Galaxy with the GDPR. The GDPR recognizes the sensitive nature of nature of genomic data, but you can still analyze them without explicit consent if you put in place appropriate countermeasures. And the next thing is that the GDPR explicitly mentioned encryption and anonymization as the most suitable countermeasures. The other thing is the availability of Galaxy flavors. So also, as we have seen for the public instance, also here we have some pre-configured Galaxy instances to support specific analysis, and that is done to speed up the user's research. So the user go there, select the set of tools that he need, deploy Galaxy and start to use them. And we have more, many of them, and one of them, for instance, is dedicated to the COVID-19 analysis. Next slide, please. How to use LaniaCare? There is an open call provided by Elixir Italy, which is called LaniaCare Trecas. Trecas is the data center that is hosting our service. And basically, there is the open call. You go there, you submit your project, and after a few days, there is a technical and scientific board, and you can, which will evaluate your project. And then after a few days, you can, if successfully evaluated, you can log into LaniaCare, deploy Galaxy, and start your work. Next slide. This is my last slide. As talked during when I talked about EOS Life, to engage with community, for example, actually, the best choice to join to this open call, this will end the 22nd of December, so there's not much time, but in the next year will be another open call for sure. Using this open call, people can submit their project. They will be evaluated from experts and then funded. Next slide. Okay, so thank you for your attention. That was all my slide, and that these are the involved institution on these services. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Marco. Thanks a lot, Giacinto.